Happy morning, children. Welcome to Blue Stars High Secondary School online classes. So today we are going to see our English class for standard 9. Okay, so before getting into the class, let me give you the thought for the day. Do not overrate what you have received, nor envy others. He who envies others does not obtain peace of mind. So this was given by Buddha. Okay. So you should not be over proud of whatever you have, okay, and nor you should not be developing hatred for what you don't have, okay. If others is having and you are not having, you should not develop hatred also. So you have to be happy and content with whatever you have, okay. If you are keeping on feeling jealous of people who are having many things other than you, you will be having no peace of mind. Okay, so you have to be happy with whatever you have. Understood, children? So with that, we just get into the lesson. So here, so today we are going to see unit 2 supplementary. Okay, so already we have completed unit 2 prose and poem part. And now we are just going to see the supplementary part. Okay, so the supplementary name is The Fun They Had. This was written by Isaac Asimov. Okay, the author is Isaac Asimov. So let us see something about the author, a brief introduction about the author. He was born on 2-1, okay, January 2nd in 1920. Okay, he was a writer and he was educated from this Columbia University in Boston. Okay, and then, he was born in Russia. Okay, so his full name is Isaac Yudovich Asimov. He's a Russian writer. Okay, children. So this is about author. And now we just see some words which you'll be coming across in this lesson. The first one is crinkly. Crinkly means with many folds. When you just open the paper, the old newspapers or some the pages of old books, when you just turn, you just hear some sound, no? The crinkly, so something like crispy, isn't it? So it's a crinkly means with many folds. Awfully, say extremely. Okay. Attic. Attic is a space just below the roof used as a storeroom. We say, no? I mean, in loft. Yeah, the loft we say. In Tamil, la paranna solluvom. That is attic. Scornful. Scornful means feeling or expressing contempt. Okay. Yes, nonchalantly means in a casual manner. Ghee is an expression of surprise. Okay, hoped. Hoped is believed. Fault, you know, mistake. And dispute is argument. Okay, I think you understand this. And now you can just see here, no? This picture. Okay, it's an imaginary high school picture, which was depicted in the French postcard. Okay, so just see, all of this connected to some wire. Okay, so that they will be like listening. Okay, the teacher don't want to just stand and shout. They can all just listen. They're connected to the wires here. So this was depicted in 1901 to 1910. Just imagine how advanced they were, isn't it? So why I'm just showing you this picture is, there's something about a school which you cannot even imagine now. Okay, it's a fictional story actually. So just see here, in this story we are just going to see some characters. It's Margie. Margie is a 11 years old girl who hates school. Okay, so she is Margie. So she does not likes to go to school at all. And then Tommy. Tommy is a 13 years old boy. Okay. And Mrs. Jones. Mrs. Jones is Margie's mother. And then mechanical teacher. He teaches to Margie and Tommy. He teaches them different subjects. And he works on the television screen. Okay, actually it is not a normal teacher. It's just a mechanical machine. Okay, so these are the characters you come across in this lesson. So The Fun They Had by Isaac Asimov. Okay, now let's get into the story. See, the story we shall read is set in the future when books and schools as we now know them will perhaps not exist. See, just imagine, already actually we are in this pandemic situation. We cannot go to school and we are all having online classes and we are learning at home. But we have a hope that all your prayers will bring back us to normal situation, isn't it? But see, in future, if all the school is just at home, so that will be a fiction story. The concept for this story, okay? Let's see here. Yeah, see, schools of future, okay? It will be a robotic teacher will be there, and they learn through computers, virtual classrooms. It is not a real classroom, okay? It's a virtual classroom. And then moving e-text, which means you don't have books. Only that computer will be, you can read only from the computer. You can just see the mechanical teacher here, isn't it? But what about nowadays school? A teacher will be there. They'll be like teaching you, isn't it? You'll be doing your homework. You'll be playing with your friends, everything. Okay. So what are the good things you will see in your school? You can just tell, okay? I mean, share your thoughts about what are the good things about your school. Okay. So with that, we just get into the story. This story is happening on 2157th year. Okay, just see, we are in 2020 now, the 2157th year. Okay, so how a student like Margie studies? I mean, we were having a normal school. Okay, because of this situation, we are having online school, isn't it? We don't know how the future school will be. So it's just an imaginary story that the future school may be like this. So just this Margie and Tommy are in the year 2157. Okay, so what happened? Even Margie has written about it in her diary. Okay, on his page number 17, May 2157th year, she wrote. What she write? Tommy found a real book. See, just imagine, even that opening itself, it's very wonderful, isn't it? Tommy found a real book, which means they have not at all seen a real book. They are very much confined only to the screen of the computers. Okay, so it was very old book. So Margie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, okay, his grandfather told him that there was time when all the stories were printed on paper. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awfully funny to read the words that stood still instead of moving the way we supposed to on the screen. You know, and then when turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had when they read it the first time. Okay, just see. What we are seeing now, that is what they have given here as a different thing. Okay, whenever you just take a book and read, will the pages move? No, isn't it? The pages will be remain still. But see here, the girl is feeling very funny. Why? Because she is used to read only through the computer screen where the words will be keeping on moving. She has to read it quickly, isn't it? But she is feeling so much fun about the letters not moving because it is a normal book and she is she feels different about the normal book because the letters are still in the book. It is not at all moving. Understood? Because her grandfather has told once when the grandfather was a little boy, they used to have the books where the letters are not moving. Okay. So, Gee, said Tommy, what a waste. When you're through with the book, you just throw it away, I guess. Our television screen must have had millions of books on it and it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away. Same with mine, said Margie. Okay. She was 11 and hadn't seen as many telebooks as Tommy had. He was 13. So, I said, Margie is an 11-year-old girl and Tommy is a 13-year-old boy. And now Tommy is telling, what are you wasting your time in seeing this old book? We have lots and lots of book in the telescreen, okay? We are in the computer. So why are you wasting your time just looking off this old book? Okay. And she said, where did you find it? And he says, in my house. He pointed without looking because he was busy reading. Okay. So what Margie asked, where did you find this book? Okay. And Tommy says, I found it in the attic. Okay. What's about it? School. So Margie was very scornful. She said, school? What is there to write about school? Because she hates school. So when the boy said, when Tommy said that the book is for about school, and Margie was feeling very much disappointed because she feels there is nothing to learn about school. Okay. Because Margie always, she hated going to school. Why she hated? Let us see there. You can just see the mechanical teacher here. Isn't it? This mechanical teacher, he used to just give lot of tests in geography. Okay. And she used to make all the tests in a bad way. She will not score good marks. And the mother was feeling very much disappointed of her performance. So the mother just called for a country inspector. So you can just see here, no? He is a country inspector. He is a little round man, okay, a chubby, plumpy man with a red face and a whole box full of tools and dials and wires. Okay. So this man, he used to smile at Margie. Because why they call this man? Just to come and check the mechanical teacher. Okay. Usually, whenever the mechanical teacher is not working properly, if any fault happens, they used to call this countryman just to repair it. Okay. You see here, Margie always hated school. But now she hated it more than ever. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography. And she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and sent for the country inspector. Okay, she was not performing well. Margie was not performing well in the test. So the mother wants to check whether is there any problem with the mechanical teacher. Okay, so how was the countryman? He was a round little man with a red face and a whole box of tools with dials and wires. So he just smiled at Margie and gave her an apple. Then he just took the teacher apart. Okay, he just took the teacher for repairing. Margie had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again. But he knew all right, and after an hour or so, there it was again. So Margie thought, like after making all the arrangements, maybe like removing, okay, like after he just removed the parts and checked that, Margie thought maybe this country inspector may not know how to assemble the part again. But he is very good. He is perfect in his work. So he has just bring the mechanical teacher just like that. So again, there was a large and black and ugly with a big screen. Okay, with all the lessons were shown and questions were asked. So Margie is feeling bad that again his mechanical teacher has came. Okay, so Margie, which part of this mechanical teacher Margie does not like is that slot, okay, where she has to just put the homework and test papers. Okay, she has to write them in a punch code format. Okay, what is that? Punch code format. So in using the punch code, they have to write all the tests. So this punch code, they have made Margie to learn when she was 6 years old. Okay, so she has to write her test in this punch code format only. And then she has to put the papers in the given slot. And then this mechanical teacher will calculate the mark and give it back. Okay. See this, the inspector had smiled after he was finished and patted Margie's head. He said to the mother, it is not the fault of the girl, but it is the fault of the mechanical teacher, because the geography sector is too quick. So she's the country inspector said, I have slowed it down to 10 years old level. Okay. See, but actually the overall pattern of the progress is quite satisfactory. And he patted Margie's head again. So what the country inspector said, See, don't worry about the girl. She is actually learning good. The problem is only with the mechanical teacher. The geography part is very much faster. Okay. So he said, I have slowed it down. So hereafter, there will be no problem at all. Okay. So she will be doing her test well. So she is studying well only. So don't worry about her. The country inspector said so. And he went. Again, Margie was disappointed. Why? Because she thought that the country inspector would take the mechanical teacher away. Isn't it? Because once it happened, the history part was not working properly. And he took this mechanical teacher for 1 month. Okay. So she was very much happy that she don't have school for a month. So she said to Tommy, why would anyone write about school? So thinking all these things, she thought there is nothing to write about school. Okay. Because for her, school is nothing but in the same house, the next to her room. And only the mechanical teacher and the girl will be there, isn't it? So this is the school for her. So she said, what is there to write about school? Tommy looked at her with very superior eyes, because it is not our kind of school, stupid. This is the old kind of school that they had hundreds and hundreds of years ago. He had loftily pronouncing the word carefully centuries ago. So what he said, see, don't think that the school is about what we are learning now. But the school is hundreds and hundreds of years ago. When this is happening in the year? Yes, 2157. Okay, so he says before 100 years ago, before centuries ago, how was the school? The book is about that only. Okay, so Margie was hate. Margie said, okay, I don't know about what type of school it is. Anyway, they had a teacher. Okay. And then he said, whatever type of school, they will be having a teacher, isn't it? And she does not like to talk about the school. See here, Margie was hurt. Well, I don't know what kind of school they had at all at that time. She read the book over his shoulder for a while, then said, anyway, they had a teacher. Okay. But Tommy said, yes, they had a teacher, but the teacher is a human. Okay. When Tommy said that, immediately Margie was asking, how could a human be a teacher? Okay. Well, she told, boys and girls things and gave them homework and asked them questions. Okay. So what is that? The human is the teacher, which is with the school which you are attending, isn't it? The human is a teacher, and the human used to teach everything. Okay. Your teacher or your sir, they used to teach you. They used to give you many things about the particular lesson, and they used to give you homework, and they used to ask you questions. This is what he's telling. And immediately they said, a human is not smart enough. Okay, immediately he was telling, but sure one is. Okay, Tommy says, no, you're wrong. A human is smart enough than a mechanical teacher. And Margie wasn't prepared to dispute that. She said, I would not want a stranger in my house to teach. So what she says, since she does not like school, she's telling all means of like opposing words to Tommy. He says, maybe they can have a human as a teacher, but a human cannot be smart as a machine. So immediately Tommy says, no, human is very much smarter than the machine. So after immediately Margie says, I don't want any stranger to be in my house, because she thought the teacher will come to her house and teach. So she said, no, I don't want any stranger to be in my house. And then Tommy was laughing heavily. He says, the teacher will not come to your house. Everybody, all the teacher and the student will go to a special building. Okay, so what is the name of that building? School. Okay, so